Hello.
Hello, everyone.
We apologize for starting a little bit late today. We've had a few technical issues, but glad that we're with you now. Welcome, everybody.
Yes, hello, hello, everyone.
So, I'm Jo.
And I'm Zina.
Hi, nice to see
Hi.
everybody. Let us know in the comments where you're from. I'm in France, and Zina.
And I am in Tunis right now.
Okay.
Hello.
I can see some people that come along every week, like Carmen and Julia. Welcome back. Manuel, April.
Manuel as well. Hello, everyone.
Let us know which countries you're in. Okay. Hi, Josu from DR Congo. Welcome to
Hi.
you.
Greetings from Sri Lanka, Dipti. Hi, Dipti. Today we have an amazing lesson planned for you guys, so I think it's worth the wait. Hello.
Hi there, we've got Egypt, Italy,
Sweden.
Syria, Poland, so many countries as usual. We love
Yes.
seeing which countries you're all in. Argentina, hi,
We have
Andrea.
hi from Mexico, Brandon. Hello. Thank you for joining us.
Okay, Pakistan, Argentina, Chin State, wow, Mongolia, Georgia, Romania, Ukraine.
Just worldwide, Ecuador as well.
Yeah, amazing. Okay, we've got a really special and romantic lesson for you today because it's a special day tomorrow in
Exactly.
lots of countries in the world. So we've got some questions for you. In your country, Zina, is Valentine's Day celebrated in
So
Tunisia?
yes, absolutely yes. Here in Tunis, Valentine's Day is celebrated and some people look forward to it to get gifts and to get spoiled, so that's great. I also have my cheesy earrings. I love just for today's lesson.
You'll be wearing them tomorrow as well, I guess, for Valentine's
Of
Day.
course, of course.
So why don't you all tell us in your country, is Valentine's Day celebrated where you are? Let us know in the comments. We'd like to know about that. Is Valentine's Day celebrated? So where I'm in France, it is it's celebrated a bit, but not as much as in the UK.
All right, but they say that Paris is the city of love.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I think they say it's like one of the most romantic cities in the world. Okay. Oh, we've got some more details here about today's session, actually.
Yes. So, should I go for it?
Go for it.
All right. So, today we're going to talk about Valentine's Day. So that's happening tomorrow. We're going to dive into a romantic story. Then it's going to be your turn to practice and maybe share your thoughts. And at the end of the lesson, there's going to be a recap of the language that we reviewed in the lesson. All right.
In the meantime, I've seen there's lots of countries where it's celebrated. Julia, Myanmar, if I remember rightly, I think Valentine's Day celebrated. I can see Philippines, Sri Lanka.
Lanka as well,
I
Romania.
saw Italy before. So lots of countries where it's celebrated. Let us know. And I can see some people are seeing what people do.
All right. So Manuel says, I can see men with red roses with boxes of chocolate, but I can't see women bringing boxes of beers for men. So here we're talking about Valentine's Day gifts, maybe.
Okay. Nigeria is celebrated often by young people. Okay, so lots of countries celebrate
I
Valentine's.
think it should be celebrated by everybody, you know. All right, so how do people celebrate Valentine's Day in your countries?
Okay, so Manuel's mentioned chocolates.
And
What else
roses.
do people do
Yes.
if it's celebrated in your country? Anna, we celebrate it in Ukraine. Okay, what do you do? What do you do to celebrate?
In Italy, of course, we celebrate Valentine's. Sure thing in Pakistan, loads of folks get into the Valentine's Day spirit, exchanging gifts and spreading love vibes.
Nice.
Nice. What kind of gifts?
Carmen, hello. Much chocolate and many flowers. Okay, yeah, classic Valentine's gifts, chocolate and
Right.
flowers.
It's the safe go-to option, I guess.
Definitely.
Chocolate and roses here in Morocco. Lovely.
Okay, I can see in Egypt people buy flowers as well. Maybe
Mm-hmm.
red roses or other flowers. I guess roses are the traditional Valentine's
Yeah. Yeah.
flower. Okay.
Ooh, unfortunately, we don't celebrate it in Egypt. Okay. All right. It depends on the person himself, or it just depends on the person and what they would like to buy, maybe for their significant other. But it's also that I think it's important to mention that Valentine is not just, for your significant other. You can also exchange gifts with your family members, or there's also something called Galentine's. So Valentine's just between friends, or you can share gifts. So I think that's really.
Exactly. Some people like to go out and celebrate with their friends or to have a nice meal with their family. So it's just about celebrating people you love in general, I guess.
Exactly, exactly.
Okay, somebody's saying dinner at a restaurant. Dipthy says we give flowers, chocolates, and jewelry, and hotels plan events for the day.
I
Okay.
want all of the above.
Yeah.
We wear red outfits and share chocolates and flowers. So this is Michael from Ghana. Really lovely.
Okay, lots of lovely ways to celebrate. Oh, Manuel says, yes, hidden lovers show up out of the blue on Valentine's Day.
Hidden lovers. So maybe that's the time of the year where you can express and share your feelings.
In Pakistan, folks hand out chocolates and even little crosses on Valentine's Day. It's not just about sweethearts, though. Lots of people give these treats to their moms, dads, and friends too. So that's what you were just saying, Zina.
Absolutely, absolutely. So in Cambodia, we celebrate with beloved people and give flowers as well as maybe have dinner together. Thank you, Kim. That sounds like a really nice plan for the day. All right.
Okay, and will you be celebrating tomorrow, Zina? Do you have plans?
I am celebrating with my family members and my friends. So I'm really excited for that. Maybe we're gonna go, have dinner and watch a movie. So
That
that's
sounds like
really
a good plan. Do any of you have plans? Last year, I made a really nice big chocolate cake, like a heart-shaped chocolate cake for my family. So I think I'll do that again this year.
Yes, and please share the picture in the group.
Oh yeah, okay, that's a challenge now, isn't it? Okay. Anybody got any plans for tomorrow?
Plans for tomorrow.
Michaela, my husband and I are going to eat pizza.
A heart-shaped pizza, maybe.
Yeah, have a
Hello.
great time.
Yes, enjoy. My wife and I usually have a giant meal in a good restaurant. That's really nice, Mash. Lovely, lovely.
Sounds
Okay.
good.
Sounds
Okay.
good.
Any more plans? Couple more plans. Maria says most shops, food, and restaurants are busy in preparation for tomorrow, and they've even prepared an area for lovers in the Philippines.
Wow, an area dedicated to people who want to celebrate. That's lovely.
Okay. Well, we've got a really special story to share with you to celebrate Valentine's Day. I hope you're going to like it. But first of all, let's find out, are you in the romantic mood? So, are you a romantic person? So, can you tell us in the comments, are you a romantic person? A, yes, absolutely. B, sometimes. Or no, not at all. So, let us know there in the comments. Let's see how many romantic people we've got watching today.
Yes.
What about you, Zina? Are you a romantic person?
Absolutely. I have to go with A. Absolutely. I am a romantic person. It's obvious by the earrings that I'm wearing. I am. I do love, you know, rom-coms. I love romantic books. So I
You're
am a romantic person.
A.
Yes. Yes.
Most people are saying either A or B.
Okay.
Eduardo says sometimes.
Sometimes. B as well. All right. Okay. Lots of B.
Sometimes for Stephanie. Oh, not at all, says Jam.
A for Maria. Okay.
Uh-huh.
Someone said, I'm super duper romantic.
Oh, Dan is. Yes, absolutely.
Okay. Ooh, Manuel says, sometimes depends on the woman who is next to me.
Okay, so a lot of people say yes, absolutely, or sometimes. We've got a few not at alls. Alexandra, mm-hmm. for example. But let's hope that you're going to get into the romantic story that we've got for you.
Yes.
Okay. Oh, there we go. Super duper
romantic. All right. Okay.
I think we've got one last question for you before we have this today's story. And?
Oh, do you believe in love at first sight? Why or why not? Oh, let us know in the comments, you guys. Do you believe in love at first sight? What do you think, Jo? Do you believe in love at first sight?
Well, I don't know. When you see in a lot of films and, you know, they often seems to be, oh, you know, their eyes meet and they fall in love. But I don't know. I think maybe there can be an attraction at first sight. But maybe love takes a bit longer to get to know somebody, my opinion. What about you? What do you think?
I have to agree with you on that because especially, you know, in movies, there's that, you know, slow shot of the camera and there's this slow motion when their eyes meet. But I don't really believe in love at first sight. So what about you guys? What do you think? Yes, I do. Love is a blind feeling.
Okay. Oh, yeah. That's an expression, isn't it? Love is blind.
Exactly. It's just a sign of admiration. Yeah, a sign. Yeah, absolutely. What do you guys think? Do you believe in love at first sight?
Ismail does. I do believe in love at first sight. Okay, we've got some romantics here, haven't we?
Yeah, I love that. Okay.
Yeah.
We're getting into the mood.
Oh, Daniel, yes, my story was love at first sight.
Oh.
Okay. Oh, I think maybe you can tell us more about that later on.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people say they've experienced their own. Come on. Yes, I believe. But it's mainly an attraction, a chemical process.
I have to agree with you there. It's only attraction at first sight, not maybe love at first sight. Mm-hmm. Once upon a time, I loved a girl, but it was a one-sided attraction or one-sided. Yeah, that also happens.
Manuel, absolutely. Yes, it happens to me a lot of times, a feeling like my stomach is full of butterflies.
All right.
And I've seen a comment from Maria saying that she fell in love with her husband at first sight. That's nice.
Seb Inglés, it depends on your age. If you're a teen, love at first sight is for sure something that happens. If you're an adult, as I am, you take a second view of it. I think that's a really nice comment and it kind of shows how you deal with love.
Ah, oh, there we go. There's the nice romantic for Maria.
That's
okay.
So
oh, wow. We could just sit here reading all of your romantic stories. But
exactly.
I think we've got a romantic story of our own to show you today.
Exactly. And they're going to help us build it as well. So that's
exactly.
really
interesting. There's going to be some decisions that you are going to have to make to see if our characters are going to really get together by the end of the story.
We have to make it work.
Let's see how our story starts. Can we see an attraction there?
Oh, wow.
They've noticed each other across this bar, cafe.
It looks really romantic.
Romantic music playing in the background.
Yes.
Okay. The cafe. So it's a chilly February afternoon. But the cozy cafe is filled with the murmur of conversations, the aroma of coffee, and the soft melody of a jazz playlist in the background. Jack notices Rose from across the room. Their eyes meet, sparking an undeniable connection.
Exciting!
What is going to happen? What do you think happens next? What are the options, Zina?
So, what happens next? And you guys have to choose in the comments. So, Jack goes over to talk to Rose, or Rose comes over to talk to Jack. Okay. What do you guys think?
It's your decision, everybody watching. You have to decide.
Exactly. Let us know in the comments. Where should we go? What should we do?
What would you do, Zina? Would you make the first move?
Putting me on the spot there, Jo. Honestly, I don't think that I would go first, just because I'm a little bit shy. So if I ever found myself in that situation, I think I would have to maybe smile. That's pretty much it. Okay, let's see. So Deep T says the first one. So Jack goes over to talk to Rose. Okay. Jack goes over. Someone said ladies first.
Yeah. Jack goes to talk to Rose.
Uh-huh. Okay.
I think Jack's winning at the moment. We have got some people saying Rose comes over.
Okay, but what do you guys think?
I think that the majority, if I see the majority, I think that people have chosen Jack.
Yes, and we have just Rose. A third option.
Do you think so?
To order another cup of coffee and smiles at Rose. I love that.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that would be quite cool, wouldn't it? Okay. There we go, Valentina's comment.
Okay, but we do have some feminists here who are saying...
We're going to have to make a choice. I think that probably Jack goes over.
Okay,
let's go with that then. So Jack goes over to Rose.
So, Zina. Yes. So when Jack is going to go over and talk to Rose, we can also say to chat Rose up or to chat someone up. So this means to talk to someone in a way that shows that you're attracted to them. A chat up line is usually a line or a question that you're going to say to show someone that you're interested in them and you want to get to know them a little bit more. And a cheesy chat up line is a very bad and embarrassing one. It's fake and not sincere. And we're going to look at examples of these in a bit. All right. So I think that everyone decided that Jack is going to chat up Rose.
I think, yeah.
Okay. So which of these cheesy chat up lines and which one do you think is the best way for Jack to start a conversation?
So we've got two questions for you here, haven't we? One is we want you to find the cheesy chat-up line. And two, we want you to find the one which is the best way to start the conversation.
Exactly. So yeah. Jack right now is going to go and chat up Rose.
So listen carefully while Zina reads the chat-up lines and decide which one, number one, which is cheesy, and number two, which is the best way to start the conversation.
All right, let's start with number one, okay? Which of these is a cheesy chat-up line? Is it A, did you fall from heaven because, girl, you're an angel? B, sup, which is short for what's up? C, do you come here often? Or D, hi there, I couldn't help but notice the book that you're reading. I just finished reading it myself. What do you think so far? All right, so which one of these lines is a cheesy chat up line that, you know, it's a bit cringe. It's not really authentic. It's practiced. Yes, a silly or a cheesy. Thank you, Manuel. That's for sure.
Uh-huh.
All right, so we're looking for the cheesy one right now.
Manuel agrees. A is a silly chat. A chat up. Absolutely. A silly chat up.
Absolutely. Too cheesy. It makes me cringe when I just say it.
Dipty agrees.
All right.
Me too. What would you do if somebody said that one to you, Zina?
A?
Yeah.
I don't think that I would even engage in the conversation. I would just politely smile and look the other way.
Right. Okay. So we think that's probably not a good idea then for Jack to use that one. Absolutely. I think, yeah, I agree with everybody that said A. That's definitely really cheesy.
Yeah.
So
we're going to go to...
We want to know which was the best one, though. Which was the best one to use? So if we're definitely not going to use the cheesy one, that's not going to really get him far. So can you remember the four chat-up lines? So we said A is cheesy, A is out.
And then B was sup.
C was, do you come here often?
Yes. And then D was... to ask about what she has in her hand, what she's doing, and find something mutual right there.
But hi there, I couldn't help but notice the book you're reading. I just finished it myself. What do you think so far? So which one do you all think that Jack should use there?
Exactly, yes.
To try to connect with...
Rose. Oh, Christina says D for an elegant conversation. Okay, D, lots of D's. D is the best one.
Somebody's saying C or D are okay. Irina thinks C. Do you come here often? Yeah.
It's a good way to start a conversation.
I think it could be.
All right. And D as well. Okay, I think.
We have to choose one. Which one shall we choose? I think... Do you think more people have chosen C or D?
I would say a lot of people chose D.
D? Yeah,
D.
Anna also says Jack can use D. Okay, I think C was okay, but should we go with D?
C was okay, but D also shows that Jack kind of sees what she's doing and he doesn't want to be too forward and is just asking about the book and what she's doing with the book. So I think that's a good one.
I think it shows he's more interested. C is maybe a little bit ordinary.
Exactly.
Okay, let's go for D then. So that's what he says about the book. Okay. Zina, do you want to read how it goes next?
Yes. So Jack says, it's my first time here, but it seems like a nice place. So what are you doing? What are you reading? Sorry. So Rose is actually reading The Notebook and she asks Jack, have you read it? Maybe I could lend it to you, but you'll have to give it back. It was a gift. Jack says, oh, I couldn't possibly accept that. How could I get it back to you? Okay.
Question from Alexander.
What does sup mean? Exactly. So sup is what's up, and it's like, hi, how are you? But it's very informal, very chill, and you're not going to use it as to chat someone up, you know? Okay. So the conversation is moving along. What do you think, Joe?
I think it looks like they're getting on pretty well. I wonder what's going to happen next, because she's said that she's reading The Notebook, which is, I think it's quite a romantic book film. And she's asked Jack, would he like to borrow it? But how can he give it back to her? That means they're going to have to exchange some kind of way, some details, some way of contacting each other afterwards.
Absolutely. I think it's really nice that she offered to lend him the book.
Very nice.
As you said, Joe, it looks like things are moving pretty nicely between them.
So this is some vocabulary we could use when people are getting along well, especially you know, just in a first instance, we could say they are hitting it. So it looks as if Jack and Rose are hitting it. What could we put there? What's the missing word? Can you put that in the comments if you know, or you can guess? What do you think we can say? Hitting it. What is it?
We just need one word.
Tiny word.
A tiny word.
Okay, so some people already got ideas too about how they can keep in touch, exchanging phone numbers or social media.
Okay. We already have answers there. That's great.
Julius
is hitting it off. Very good. Yes, yes.
People are saying off, aren't they? Quite a few.
Hitting it up.
No, I don't think that's the right one. No. Miranda says off.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, bright days. So people are either saying hit it up or hit it off.
Off. Okay.
Which one sounds better? To hit it off or to hit it up?
Yes.
Okay, to get on well immediately, says Manuel. That's the meaning of it. Yeah.
That is the meaning, yes.
Okay, so April says off. Oh, hit it out.
Hit it out. Off the park.
That's with a ball, probably. Hit it off. Okay. Are they right?
Let's see. Very good. Everyone who said hitting it off. So if you and another person are hitting it off, it means that you like someone and become friendly very quickly. And we say that you're hitting it off.
All right. So where were we in our story? They're hitting it off.
Exactly.
She's offered to lend him her book, the notebook. Mm-hmm. But he needs to find a way to get the book back. And I think there she's sort of suggesting that they get together again if she wants to lend him the book.
Perhaps. Okay, yeah. So what should Jack do next? So Rajul Sharqi says now they're close enough to exchange numbers, perhaps.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
April Moon, exchange their phone numbers or social media accounts. What do you think is the best idea there? The phone number
phone
or the
number?
Social media account? Yeah, what would you do?
Honestly, let's see what they're going to say, but I do have a preference that I'm going to keep a little bit secret. Mm. Okay, he needs a phone number. Share phone number. Share addresses or phone numbers. Okay.
I think I wouldn't give my address straight away. I wouldn't want Jack to know where I lived just
perhaps
yet.
You mean like an email address, perhaps?
Maybe, yeah.
All right, so what should Jack do next? Should he ask Rose for her number or her WhatsApp, give Rose his business card, or add Rose on Instagram? So IG is short for Instagram. So you asked me, Jo, which one would I prefer? Personally, I don't feel comfortable enough giving someone I don't know my private phone number. So just like Manal, I would maybe add him on Instagram. Exactly. Exchange Instagram name, not the phone number. Mm-hmm. Just so I'm a bit more in control of, you know, if he turns out to...
Not to be not quite as nice as she thinks he is.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay, so lots of people saying either Instagram
or phone number.
Phone number. Nobody says the business card. That would be a bit formal in this situation, wouldn't it? The business card.
Completely agree. It's a bit, yeah. WhatsApp? Okay.
Right.
It's not safe to give a phone number. I have to agree with you there, Maria.
Yeah. Perhaps in this first instance, it could be better with the Instagram account.
Mm-hmm,
maybe the phone number would come later.
Could be, yes, absolutely. Yeah.
Okay.
All right. So shall we go?
Yeah.
Instagram?
I think we've got 50-50 here in the comments for Instagram or WhatsApp. But I think from what you've said, maybe Instagram, that would be a more cautious way to exchange details for the first time.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Okay.
Okay, so let's go on Instagram.
Okay, or somebody is saying Facebook. Could be Facebook.
All right.
Okay, so now our couple are connected and they both go home feeling great. Okay, so I guess he's taken the book as well.
Mm-hmm.
But perhaps they shouldn't get too carried away. So if you get carried away, that means going too quickly?
Yes.
Right. Okay. So what should they do next?
Next.
What do you think?
So Manuel says add Rose on his maybe Instagram just in case he decides to go on with it.
Okay.
So they add each other on Instagram. Now what? What's going to happen now?
What do they do? So do you think they should play it cool and wait a little while before they send each other a message?
So, okay. So someone said chatting on Instagram. They could start chatting on Instagram. Yes. Why not? Yes. Yeah, so should Jack wait for Rose to reach out to him? Should he text her and say, hey, thank you so much for lending me that book. What should happen
now? Somebody says invite her to dinner straight away.
Straight away.
Straight away, or play it a bit cool for a while before you invite them for dinner. Time to tread on eggshells, says Deep V. So when you tread on eggshells, you have to go really carefully.
Exactly, yes. They're going to get to know each other and chat through messages on Instagram first.
Kat has a good idea. Click on a picture you like. Carmen, but if Jack lends the book, that means he has the confidence in Rose. And Rose must have confidence too. Right. So maybe they need to chat a little bit to get this kind of confidence and trust, to start to trust each other.
Oh, click like or like a picture on their Instagram. Just show that, you know. That you like, they like, okay, that's really. Manuel says, don't think twice, carry away.
Alexander would go straight for it and invite for a coffee or a dinner.
That could be nice.
Okay. So we got some more vocabulary here. So to play it cool. So if you decide to play it cool, you behave in a calm way and pretend that you're not really interested, even though you really are. So if you play it cool, perhaps you just like a picture or something instead of straight away inviting somebody out for dinner.
Yes. Okay. So should they play it cool? Jack thinks of three possible next steps. Which should he choose? So should Jack leave comments and likes under all of Rose's pictures and videos? Wait for Rose to DM him first or send him a direct message first, or like and reply to a story that Rose posted and find another mutual interest.
In the first one, it says leave comments and likes under all of her pictures and videos. Every single one. Okay, so that shows he's keen, but maybe too keen.
I have to agree with you on that. Imagine she has like 100 pictures on Instagram. Is he going to like all the pictures?
Yeah, that would be maybe a bit too much. That wouldn't really be playing it cool. And
no, that maybe, would just be just like
maybe a little bit creepy even.
A little bit, yeah. Or just like just love bombing. That's too much.
Love bombing. Okay, that's an interesting expression. We'll come to that one in a minute. Alexandra says the third one. So Alexandra thinks like and reply to a story and find a mutual interest.
Okay.
Anil agrees there.
Lots of people were choosing C.
Jamil also.
Ask her some polite questions to get to know each other. Okay.
Okay, good ideas. Nobody says to wait. Oh, also, yeah, Olena says to wait. Wait for Rose to DM him first.
Really?
Okay.
Okay. So Rose is going to take then the first step. I'm going in the third. Reply to a story. You throw the stone just in case. Yeah, I like that one.
Okay, so nobody has said number one. Everybody's agreed that number one is not a good option.
No, absolutely not. I have to agree with you on that. Some people are choosing one, but yes, as I said before, feels a bit like it's love bombing. So
what is this? If we say love bombing, what does it mean? Does it mean you're A, being very romantic, B, sending someone a big bunch of flowers, Or C, showing too much affection too soon in a relationship.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think there? A, B, or C, what does that mean, love bombing?
All right, it doesn't have to be too insistent. Okay, so when you just like insist and try to show that you're there for that person. So what does love bombing mean, you guys? A, B, or C? Okay. C as well. Just
Lots of agreement here for C.
Absolutely. So love bombing. This is one of the options that we had in the previous slide.
Mm-hmm. Because bombing, that doesn't sound very positive, does it? That sounds more like
absolutely not, yes.
Negative thing. So
and when you overwhelm someone with something and it's the opposite of playing it cool, right?
Absolutely. And so this would be probably a red flag if somebody is love bombing.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So well done, everyone. It is actually C. Love bombing is showing too much affection too soon in a relationship. You still don't know that person. This is just maybe like the second conversation you're going to have. So it's a bit too forward and too much to leave likes and comments and DMs straight away, right, Jo?
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we've decided that Jack is going to play it cool and he's going to find a mutual interest. He's going to reply or like one of her stories or one of
correct.
Her posts.
Yes.
Right, to find if they've got something in common. Okay, yeah. So I wonder what that's going to be.
Me too. I think it's I'm really excited.
Okay. Oh, more vocabulary.
Yes. So we mentioned that love bombing is definitely a red flag. And we reviewed this before. So a red flag is a warning sign that someone might not be a good person, perhaps for you. So I think I saw in the comments that it's quite like dangerous behavior or something that should signal kind of a warning. This is not really healthy, perhaps. Exactly. So that is love bombing is a red flag this soon in the relationship.
Okay. So we haven't got any red flags yet with our couple. Things are going well. They're hitting it off. Are they ready to move on to the next stage?
Yes. Now Jack is going to like and maybe answer Rose's story.
Okay. And how is she going to react?
Exciting.
Yeah, let's see what happens.
Okay. Okay, so we are looking at the conversation. And I believe this is when Rose DMs Jack first, if I'm not mistaken. So let's look at this option. So Jack waits for Rose to send a DM first. She says, "Hey, Jack, did you have a chance to read the book?" And then Jack says, "Actually, I lost it." That's not pretty good. Actually, I lost it. I left it in a cab. Sorry. Then Rose says, "That book was a gift from my grandmother. How could you?" Oh no.
Oh dear, that would be a red flag, right?
That is definitely a red flag.
Then he lost the book. Okay, but luckily I think that's not what's going to happen, is it?
I hope not. Exactly. No. So Manuel says, "Cut off immediately."
Yeah. That would be very irresponsible. I think we shouldn't take that option.
No, let's not go there.
Let's make them have a little bit more of a conversation to connect a little bit more. Okay.
So let's try again.
We don't want that one. We don't want that option. We want something better to happen to our couple.
Exactly. We want a happy ending. Do you agree, you guys? Do we want a happy ending or do we want a realistic one?
No, we want the happy one.
Let's go for a happy ending.
Okay, let's try again. This one's happier. Oh no!
You have to let us know in the comments. Do you want a happy ending? Because this is what we want. But if you guys want it to end here, let us know.
They want the happy ending.
They want the happy ending.
Wants a happy ending.
Okay.
Yeah, this is looking better already. Yes, happy ending. Okay. Yeah, okay. Let's go for this one.
Let's go for this one. Okay. So we just have to go back to the beginning of the conversation. But basically, apparently, Rose posted a video of Taylor Swift. So Jack says, oh, wow, I love Taylor Swift. And I actually watched the Eras Tour last month. So that's great. They have something in common. And then Rose says, hey, Jack, oh, wow, we have a lot in common, right? Let's see it again. There you go. All right. So that's great. We have a lot in common. So Jack says, okay, so we both like reading and Taylor Swift. What else are you interested in? So Rose says, well, this might be a bit weird, but I really like bungee jumping. Uh-oh. And then Jack says, oh, I'm actually afraid of heights. So that's a non-starter.
Oh, no. So that's not going to be an option for their date then, going bungee jumping.
No.
Is this a red flag now for Jack?
Oh, I don't know.
Rose likes bungee jumping.
I don't know. I don't think so. I mean, she's allowed to have her own hobbies.
Of course. As long as she doesn't force him to jump from a great height on an elastic.
Would you guys go bungee jumping to impress someone on a first date?
Manuel says, no, sorry, I'm afraid of heights.
Exactly. Just be yourself, man.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. Somebody said she was talking about The Notebook, so talking about movies could be okay. I think that could be a good one.
Ah, okay. Yeah. All right. Perhaps. Okay. Okay, so we have a really nice question. Go ahead.
How long should you wait before asking someone out on a date? Okay, so they've been chatting a little bit now, maybe about bungee jumping or about
things in common in Taylor's movies,
all sorts of things. Is it time now for one of them to ask the other out on a date? Mm. How long should you wait? Like a day? A week?
A month?
What's the right answer?
What do you guys
think? What do you all think? How long should you wait before asking someone out on a date?
Okay.
Somebody says 2 weeks.
2 weeks? Okay. Maybe it takes a month.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So 2 weeks or a month of messaging each other and getting to know each other a little bit first?
Maybe, depending on how things go. Okay, lovely. So what about if we try, we'll dive in to see.
Dive in the sea. Okay, so not the bungee jump, so to go diving.
Okay, so Manuel maybe says a week.
Mm-hmm.
A 3 week period. Okay, that sounds really calculated. Why is that? Let us know.
Took me 3 months, but finally we got married. It's a true story.
3 months.
That's nice. Six months at least. Okay, so this really varies from person to person. I guess you have to get the feeling depending on the situation.
Okay, so it depends on the age. Teens don't waste time. Adults think a little bit longer. So here we're just talking about the first date. We're not making any promises. This is just the first time we're going to see each other. This duration depends whether I really fancy him or her. Okay. So let's say on average, a week or two for men takes 1 week. Okay.
So we've got really variable ideas here from like 1 week to 6 months, maybe 2 weeks after developing the chit chat.
Absolutely. Six months. Wow. Okay. So Jack has to suggest the location of the date. So should they or should Jack suggest to go to a restaurant? A walk by the river at night, meet Jack's parents.
What do you all think? Which one should he suggest? the restaurant, the walk by the river at night, or meeting his parents?
I'm seeing two red flags right here.
I'm definitely seeing a red flag with the walk by the river at night for a first date.
Thank you, John.
Oh, that's a lovely comment.
Okay, so let's just go through the options, shall we, Jo?
Yeah.
You said something about the walk by the river at night.
To me, that doesn't really seem safe. If a guy suggests to a girl for a first date, a walk by the river at night, sounds a bit dangerous to me.
Absolutely agree. Absolutely agree.
Definitely, we should not take that option.
So we're just going to remove that option.
Uh-huh.
Meet Jack's parents.
Mm.
Mm, someone said, meet my parents is too fast for the first date. Absolutely agree. Let's not.
Yeah, the first one, simple is the best, says Kat.
Oh,
meet my parents so fast for the date. Yeah, mm-hmm. I think that would come much later.
Yes.
So it's always good to have a conversation while having a meal. Right, exactly. So the restaurant, that will give them a chance to get to know each other better.
Absolutely, absolutely. And then Rose is going to feel quite comfortable being in a public space with other people around her. So just making sure that she's safe.
A simple walk in the afternoon. Yeah, maybe if you want a walk in daylight and somewhere where there's lots of other people around.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Meeting the parents early is formal.
Absolutely.
So I think the restaurant is what we should go for here.
Absolutely. Let's go to the restaurant now.
So they're ready for their first date.
Yes, I'm really happy that they're hitting it off.
Thank goodness they've got this far.
It was going to end 5 minutes ago, but
Here they are in the restaurant. Looked like a really romantic restaurant, didn't it? With the lovely
music and the
dim lights and everything.
I'm really excited. Let's see what's going to happen now.
Mm-hmm. What's going to happen at the restaurant?
Okay, we have conversation going. Okay, so they chose a restaurant. So Jack says, by the way, there's a new Italian place that just opened. I'd love to take you there. Rose says, I love Italian food. I'm in. And then Jack says, then it's a date. Wonderful. So that's done. And that's how Jack asked Rose out on a date. Maybe it took them a week.
Sorry, what did you say?
Maybe it took them a week. Maybe he asked her out after a week.
Yeah, right, exactly. Yeah, a week or 2 weeks, or we're not sure how long, but they're there now. They're at the restaurant.
Yes.
Okay. The restaurant buzzes with the ambient sound of chatter and clinking glasses. Soft, romantic lighting casts a warm glow over the tables. That sounds great, doesn't it?
It sounds lovely, yes.
So, what's going to happen now?
Mm-hmm.
Somebody says, good choice, an Italian restaurant.
Right, absolutely.
Great food. Okay. Yes. So,
all right.
Hmm.
So, what topic should Jack start to talk about? Should he talk about ex-partners and previous relationships? Food allergies and health problems, or hobbies? We have to choose the subjects now. What are they going to talk about?
What do you think? Put in the chat, what do you think? Should Jack talk about ex-partners and previous relationships, food allergies and health problems, or hobbies?
This is a romantic date.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure that he should talk about his ex partner or previous relationships.
I think that's something you definitely should not talk about when you're on a date.
Mm. Someone said ex-partners, yes. Oh no. I don't want to know.
Okay, Kat says, get to know each other, to get to know each other more by asking about hobbies. Okay.
Okay, Carmen says it's important to talk about hobbies and all the topics are boring.
Oh, tell us then, Alexandra, what would you talk about?
Yes,
Give us a
please let us
topic, a good
know.
topic to talk about on a date.
All right.
Hobbies would be an open door to hit it off. Okay, they can find something in common there.
Okay, so
So type in the chat A, B, or C, or if you're like Alexandra
Alexander.
and you've got another idea, tell us about other ideas, things or things that you think are good to talk about on a date, or things you think are a definite no to talk about on a date.
Julia says, to begin with, hobbies are the best choice from a positive aspect.
Okay. If we've got other ideas, tell us if you think it's a good idea or a bad idea. Because Gorse says the weather, obviously.
The weather, obviously. I think it's a very basic topic to start with, maybe. Like, oh, it
Yeah.
was raining when I got here.
Exactly. Why not? Alexandra, I would like to speak about personal progress. Okay. So your hopes and your ambitions and your goals maybe for the future.
Accomplishments as well, maybe the things that
Right?
she accomplished, that would be really interesting. So talk about ex-partners is the red flag. Hobbies, of course. Okay.
Okay. What about talking about good and delicious food? Right, yeah, because you're in a restaurant.
Yes, absolutely. So any allergies to seafood, gluten, peanut milk, etc. So maybe talk about food allergies.
Could be important if you're in a restaurant and you do have an allergy,
Absolutely.
but maybe you want to
Let's
develop
go.
the conversation on about a different topic.
Okay, so we're going to go with hobbies.
Okay.
And then, okay, so what are your hobbies? Well, I really enjoy hiking and I love reading. What about you? What are you passionate about?
Okay, so the conversation's going fine, it's going well, but Rose keeps getting distracted by her phone. It keeps buzzing. Should she check her messages and text back, or put her phone on mute and keep talking with Jack?
Oh
What
no.
do you think? Tell us in the comments, what should she do about her phone that keeps buzzing?
This is, well, I don't know. I have a strong opinion on this about using your phone when you're on a date or, if someone's talking to you and you're right here just texting. I don't think that that's a good thing to do. Okay, so.
No, I don't think it's very polite. And I think most people seem to agree with us here because everybody's saying B, put the phone on mute, second option. I think it's the only option, isn't it?
Is absolutely the only option.
Yeah.
If she wants to have a second date, then should be to put her phone on mute.
I think that that's what she has to
Yes.
do. Okay. Let's do that then. Put the
Let's
phone on mute. Put the phone
okay.
on mute and keep talking to Jack. If you want to keep this going, that's what you have to do.
Yes.
Okay. Your
So,
turn to read, Zina.
okay, so they are lost in conversation. Laughter and shared stories have filled their evening. The waiter approaches with the bill, placing it on the table.
Okay, so who do you think should pay the bill on a first date? What's
Okay.
your opinion? Tell us your opinion in the comments.
In the
Who
comments.
do you think should pay the bill on a first
And
date?
let us know if in your countries you have, a certain rule or something that you're, not a rule, but something that you're used to doing. So who do you think should pay the bill on a first date? He
He
should.
should for sure. Okay.
So should
Irina has said, pay Dutch.
Dutch.
Okay. Is it pay Dutch or something a little bit different?
He has to pay. All right. So he we're talking about Jack has to foot the bill. I will pay.
Manuel says, I will pay the bill. Okay.
He wants to sponsor them to go on a date.
Jack will pay the bill. Okay. So here are some options.
Yes.
Shall I read them?
Go for it.
Okay, so who do you think should pay the bill on the first date? So go Dutch. Jack picks up the check, split the bill equally. Rose picks up the check, or do a runner? Okay, what do you think? Do we understand all of those expressions? Go Dutch, split the bill, do a runner. What's the difference between all of these? Irina said pay Dutch, so I think go Dutch. Olena says 50-50.
50-50,
Right,
so
so
maybe.
which one would that be? That would be split the bill equally.
Yes.
Going
Going
Dutch.
Dutch is a good idea too. The girl has to pay, all right.
Okay. What do we mean exactly with go Dutch?
Man
Len, you are, I live
only
in China. Okay.
all right, so what do you think go Dutch means?
What does that mean?
Dutch. So,
Okay.
yes.
So if you go Dutch, each person pays for their own food or if ticket or whatever, if you're at the cinema, to pick up the check, the bill, or the tab, then you pay the whole bill for everyone. To split the bill, you share the cost of something equally, 50-50, or do a runner, leave a place quickly without paying the bill.
I don't think they should do that one, to be honest.
No, that would just, no, I think that that would be not the good option here, would it? If you
Good
want to impress somebody, come on quickly, let's do a runner. Split
Okay.
the bill equally, says Pina.
Lots of different answers.
Yeah.
It's the man who pays in the first date, and then maybe 50-50.
Right. Okay, interesting, isn't it? In different countries, there's sort of different etiquette for a first date. Split
Yes.
the bill equally. Manuel, do a runner. The special
Okay.
word in Spanish, okay.
Yes. Jack should pay, split the bill equally. Wang says, thank you, Wang. In my country, it would be more polite if he pays the bill. Right. I think so. It depends on customs, traditions, or if, Jack invited Rose out, then he should pay since it was his idea. If Rose, had invited him out, vice versa. Or maybe
What should we
just
say? Should we say they split the bill?
let's have them split the bill.
Okay, they can split the bill and pay 50-50.
Okay, so Rose says, I had a great time tonight, Jack. Thank you. And Jack replies, it was my pleasure. I had a really nice time and I would love to see you again.
Oh.
What's gonna happen next?
What do you think? What do you all think happens next? Do you think that they're going to have another date? Do you think
Ooh.
their relationship will continue?
Should they go on a second date?
What do you think? Will they find more things in common?
Or should they just ghost each other? Another date, okay.
Another date for
Okay.
sure.
So we're choosing a happy ending for these two lovebirds.
Yeah, I think we do. Their love is in bloom, yes. Oh, they kiss goodnight and leave with the promise of a beautiful beginning.
The end.
Oh,
I'm really happy.
thank you. Thanks for joining in. Oh, somebody say now they can exchange them.
Good one.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So we saw quite a lot of new vocabulary, or maybe it was new for some of you, some of it was new. We had, first of all, to chat someone up, to talk to someone in a way that shows that you're attracted to them.
And then a chat-up line. It's a question you've rehearsed to show someone that you're interested in them. This could be a question or a statement.
Cheesy is embarrassing, fake, and not sincere.
Hit it off to like someone and become friendly very quickly.
Love bombing, showing too much affection too soon in a relationship.
And ghosting to cut off all contact with someone.
Okay, so which of these were any of these new for you today? We've
We
got
have
some
a couple
more.
more, yes.
So to go Dutch, each person pays for their own food, ticket, etc.
To pick up the check, bill, or tab. So they all mean the same thing. It's just one is British and the other is American English. To pay the whole bill for everyone.
To split the bill, share the cost of something equally, 50-50.
A non-starter, which was the bungee jumping. It's something with no chance of success. Don't even think about it.
A red flag, so a warning sign that someone might be a bad person.
And to do a runner is to leave a place quickly without paying the bill.
Okay, which one did you like? Which expressions were new for you? Which did you like best? And which will you use in real life?
Let us know in the comments. Tell us.
Ingrid says, thanks for the story. It was romantic.
Thank you. It really was. I'm really happy for them. And I didn't know if you guys noticed, but did the names Jack and Rose remind you of something?
Can we say from a film?
Yes, just a film. From a film.
Divthi says, great story. Glad you enjoyed it. Thank you so much, Divthi. Go Dutch. Okay, so that was new for you. Was that a new one for you today, Anna?
Yes. Thank you.
You're welcome, Saku.
Thank you.
Yes.
So there are the two Titanic. Wonderful.
Okay, the question is, who gave the first step for the date? If it was the man, he has to pay the bill. Okay, so you're still thinking about the bill.
Okay.
Do a runner? Was that a new one for you? Carmen, thank you for today. Vocabulary, stories, explanations. You make my day. Oh, it makes our day having everybody join in and participate so much in the comments.
Oh, great. Thanks a bunch. I learned a lot. I will try to use them. Yes, please do. And let us know in the comments if you use them. To do a runner. I think lots of people like that. To do a runner.
Okay. I hope that's not the one you'll be using in real life, because that's what... Don't do it.
Don't do it. Don't use it.
No. Okay. Well, thank you all for joining us today. It's been really fun. We're going to be back with another live lesson next Tuesday. Mm-hmm. And in the meantime, happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day, you guys. And thank you so much for joining us today. I hope we gave you a little bit of some ideas to use for tomorrow, maybe. You.
Okay, I'll use all of them in my English. That's good. Great to read.
Thank you, everyone. Have a lovely day wherever you are. We'll see you guys soon.
See you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.